Welcome to Sayuji Yoga with Pritha and Hardik. I'm Pritha Bhatt and I'm back with yet another video about Patanjali Yoga Darshan MCQs, specially about Samadhi Pada. So let's begin. The first question that you are seeing on the screen is, three types of pramana accepted in Yoga Darshan are, your options are Agam, Anuman and Pramana. The next is Pratyaksha, Anuman and Agam. The next is Shravana, Manana and Nididhyasana. And the last one is Purvavata, Sheshavata and Samanyato Drashta. And your correct answer is option number B, Pratyaksha, Anumana and Agam. Now friends, we all know that there are five types of vritti which are mentioned in Patanjali Yoga Darshan. So in which sutra do we find that? That is Vrittayaha Panchatayaha Klishta Aklishta. That is sutra number 5. Now this sutra number 6 talks about Pramana, Viparyaya, Vikalpa, Nidra, Smritayaha, which are the five types of the vrittis. Now, which are the three types of Pramana? So that is mentioned in Sutra number 7, which says that Pratyaksha Anumana Agama Pramanani. But what is Pramana? Friends, vritti which gives valid knowledge is known as Pramana vritti. And there are three types of Pramana. They are Pratyaksha, Anumana and Agama. Now the meaning of Pratyaksha is direct perception, Anumana is inference and Agam is authentic testimony. So our answer is Pratyaksha, Anumana and Agama are the three Pramanas accepted in Yoga Darshan. The next question is, the knowledge of objects arising due to the contact of senses to external object is known as Agama Pramana, Anumana Pramana, Apratyaksha Pramana or Pratyaksha Pramana. And all of us know that the correct answer should be Pratyaksha Pramana. Now, why so? Now friends, what is the meaning of Pratyaksha? Prati plus Aksha. Prati is each and Aksha is eyes. But friends, we have to take all the indriya into consideration and we should not restrict ourselves only to the eyes. Now friends, every time when we use our sense organs to perceive the object to give the knowledge is known as Pratyaksha Pramana. Now always remember that through Pratyaksha Pramana we get Vishesha Gnana. They can also ask you a question that through Pratyaksha Pramana what kind of Gnana is achieved? So your answer is Vishesha Gnana. And remember there are six types of Pratyaksha: Shravana, Sparshana, Chakshusha, Rasana, Granaja and Manasa. So also there can be a question of which are the six Pratyaksha, so you know the answers. Now friends, remember that these six types of Pratyakshas are not mentioned in Patanjali Yoga Darshan, but you should have knowledge of this. Let's move towards the next question. Instrument of judgment is known as Pratyaksha, Sanumana, Anumana and Shabda. And the correct answer is option number C, Anumana. Now what does Anumana mean? So it is Anu plus Mana. So Anu is to follow and Mana is to know or to measure. Now friends, Anuman means inference. Now inference is possible only about known object. If you have known that object in past, then only you can infer about it. Otherwise inference is not going to be possible. Inference always follows Pratyaksha Pramana. And inference can never be the first knowledge. Always remember that. They can also ask you, dash can never be the first knowledge. So the answer is inference. Now for example, there is the example of smoke and fire. We can infer about smoke only if we have seen smoke and fire together in the past. Therefore, instrument of judgment is known as Anumana. Yena hi anumiyate tada anumanam. Okay, let's move further. Dash is the pramana which means testimony, or the perception arises due to the words of a Siddha Purush is called as Shabda, Vyapti, Arthapatti or Hetvabhyas. And the correct answer is Shabda. Now friends, you must be wondering that there is no mention of Shabda Pramana in entire Patanjali Sutra. But friends, Shabda Pramana is nothing but Agama Pramana, which we already know, Pratyaksha, Anumana, Agama, Pramanani. So to confuse you, they can ask you such question. Now friends, Shabda Pramana is useful in the circumstances where no sense evidence is available, as well as if there are not sufficient grounds for inference. So whenever there is no possibility of pratyaksha, there is no possibility of inference, what comes in the picture is Shabda Pramana. Now friends, here we have to depend simply on what others say. But there is one condition, that the person should be apta. Now what do I mean by apta? Apta means yathartha vakta. Now what is yathartha vakta? The one who speaks the truth is yathartha vakta. So apta person should be able to meet two conditions, that person should have right knowledge himself, and the second condition is he or she should be able to impart that knowledge without any mistake. Therefore, verbal testimony of an apta person or a siddha purush is known as Shabda Praman or Agam Praman. Hope this is very clear to you. The next question, which vritti is based on false perception and does not correspond to the actual object? Your options are vikalpa, nidra, viparyaya and smriti. And the correct answer is viparyaya. Now friends, we can find this sutra 0.8 about viparyaya, that is viparyayo mithya gyanam atadarupa pratishtham. Okay friends, now chitta vritti, which creates mithya gyana, is known as viparyaya vritti. Now in case of viparyaya, there is really no object existing on which the knowledge may be based. That is why it is known as atadarupa pratishtham. Now friends, let's take an example. Now when we mistake a rope for a snake, okay, our knowledge is incorrect, because the thing that actually exists before us, which we take to be a snake, is actually a rope. So that is a mithya gyan, which is viparyaya. Let's move further. The verbal knowledge which is devoid of actual substance is known as pramana, viparyaya, vikalpa, nidra and smriti. And the correct answer is option number D, vikalpa, which says that shabda gnana anupati vastu shunyo vikalpaha, which is given in the sutra number 9. Now friends, vikalpa is imagination without the basis of an object. Now it does not mean that it has no object, but the object mentioned in the statement is non-existent. It is cognized only with the help of the words. Let me give some example. Now you must have heard flying horse or flying elephant, or also there is something called Akashi Pushpa, the flower that grows in the sky. And in the philosophy, there is a very commonly given example is Sasashringa, means the rabbit which has the horn. Friends, no rabbit has the horn, no pushpa or no flower grows in the sky, or horse does not fly, or neither the elephant flies. So the knowledge which is cognized only by the words and which does not exist in reality is known as your vikalpa. Okay, let's move further. The question is, smriti is a vritti where? Your options are, when one remembers the past event every moment, or not allowing the experience of the object or instance to escape from the chitta, or when the chitta is filled with the past experiences, or when the chitta has absence of any experience. And the correct answer is option number B, which says that not allowing the experience of the object or instance to escape from the chitta. Now friends, sutra number 11 talks about it. Anubhuta vishaya asampramosha smritihi. Okay, it says that not allowing the experience of the object or instant to go out of the chitta is known as the smriti vritti. Let's move further. The next question is, which is the second last vritti mentioned in the list of panchataya vritti? Now friends, we all know that Patanjali Yoga Darshan Samadhi Pada talks about vritti, especially five types of vritti. Now here you should remember the sutra very well. Okay, if you don't know the sutra, how will you say that which is the second last vritti? They can ask you anything. They can ask which is the third last vritti or XYZ. So we should know that प्रमाण विपर्य विकल्प नद्रा स्मृति ही. ओके सो विच इज द सेकेंड लास्ट स्मृति. फर्स्ट इज प्रमाण विपर्य विकल्प निद्रा एंड स्मृति. सो करेक्ट आंसर इज निद्रा इज द सेकेंड लास्ट स्मृति. लेट्स मूव फर्दर. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज फोर्थ स्टेज ऑफ अपर वैराग्य इज नोन एज. ऑप्शन आर पर वैराग्य, वशीकार वैराग्य, एकेंद्रिय वैराग्य एंड द लास्ट ऑप्शन गिवन हियर इज व्यतिरेक. ओके एंड योर करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन नंबर बी वशीकार वैराग्य. नाउ फ्रेंड्स वी ऑल नो दैट पतंजलि योग दर्शन टॉक्स अबाउट अभ्यास एंड वैराग्य. नाउ दिस क्वेश्चन इज स्पेसिफिकली अबाउट वैराग्य. नाउ फ्रेंड्स देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ वैराग्य, अपर वैराग्य एंड पर वैराग्य. नाउ व्हाट इज अपर मीन? अपर मीन्स नियर एंड पर मीन्स फार. सो द वैराग्य दैट कम्स इन द इनिशियल स्टेज ऑफ स्पिरिचुअल प्रैक्टिसेस इज नोन एज अपर वैराग्य एंड द वैराग्य दैट कम्स इन द लेटर स्टेज ऑफ स्पिरिचुअल प्रैक्टिस इज नोन एज पर वैराग्य. ओके नाउ पतंजलि हैज नॉट यूज्ड वर्ड अपर वैराग्य इन एंटायर पतंजलि योग दर्शन. He rather uses the term Vashikara Vairagya instead of using Apara Vairagya. Now friends, Vashikara is the fourth type or fourth stage of Apara Vairagya. Okay, now, so which are the previous three stages? First is Yatamana, second is Vyatireka, third is Ekendriya and the last one is Vashikara Vairagya. Now friends, let me just explain you very briefly what these are about, because if there is a question you should be able to answer, because trust me these days NTA UGC has raised the bar, so they might ask you such questions. So I have developed the questions which are not only the straightforward questions, you have to actually study and you have to use your brains. So what is Yataman? Yataman is when one starts to take the efforts towards detachment through dosha darshan. Vairagya becomes possible. The next is Vyatirek. What is Vyatirek? Vyatirek is examination. Now, examining our own mind to find out for which object we have Vairagya and for which object we have Raga. When we do examination about our own Raga and Vairagya kind of a thing, that is called Vyatireka. The next is Ekendriya. Now, what do I mean by Ekendriya? Controlling the mind which is tempted to go towards the attachment is known as Ekendriya. The next is Vashikara. The last one is Vashikara. What does Vashikara means? No possibility to go back to the Raga state. That is, having complete control over Vairagya is known as Vashikara. So that is, Drashta Anushavika Vishaya Vitrushnasya Vashikara Sangna Vairagyam. When the person has detachment from drashta vishaya. Okay, so what do I mean by drashta vishaya? Visible vishaya or seen vishaya or material objects. And anushravika vishaya. Now what do I mean by anushravika vishaya? Anu plus shrava is equal to Veda. That is karmakanda part of Veda. I am not saying the entire Veda, only the karmakanda part of the Veda. Or the divine objects. Such person's detachment is known as Vashikara Vairagya. Okay, friends, I went a little bit in detail about this, but it is very important to remember that Vashikara Vairagya is the fourth stage of Apara Vairagya. Let's move further. The next question is Vitaraga Vishayam Va Chittam is the method of having Chitta Prasadana, having Manasthiti Nibandhani for Antaraya Abhava or for attaining Para Vairagya. And your answer is option number B, having Manasthiti Nibandhani. Now friends, Vitaragam Vishayam Vachittam is explained in the Sutra number 37 of chapter number 1, which is the method of Manasthiti Nibandhani. Now friends, what is Manasthiti Nibandhani? It is the practice to achieve stability of mind. Now, if a person meditates on a subject such as a person who has transcended their desires, okay, example, the saint, the guru, then such person's chitta becomes steady. Now friends, here chitta takes the form of alambana. And if the alambana is the virakta chitta, then yogi's chitta too gets detached, which means vitaraga vishayam va chittam. Okay friends,
Let's move further. The next question is, two types of pravrittis explained by sage Patanjali in Samadhipada are Jyotishmati pravritti, Vishayavati pravritti, Samapatti pravritti or Savritti pravritti. Now friends, if you see, there are lots of options given and the correct answer is option number 4, A and B. A is Jyotishmati pravritti and the B is Vishayavati pravritti. Now friends, two pravrittis are explained in the methods of achieving stability of mind, that is Manasa Sthiti Nibandhani. Now friends, what is pravritti? Pravritti means vritti for specific objects. Okay, there are two types of pravritti, Vishayavati pravritti and Jyotishmati pravritti. Now what is Vishayavati pravritti? Pravritti for divine or subtle Vishaya is known as Vishayavati pravritti. And what is Jyotishmati pravritti? Objects of Jyotishmati pravritti can be either buddhi or asmita. Okay, so that is the basic difference between Vishayavati pravritti and Jyotishmati pravritti. Now friends, mention of Vishayavati pravritti can be found in the sutra, which is Vishayavati va pravritti utpanna manasa sthiti nibandhani, and the mention of Jyotishmati pravritti can be found in Vishoka va Jyotishmati. Hope this is very clear to you. Let's move further. The knowledge that is gained after having complete control over the Nirvichara state is known as Adhyatma Prasad, Rutumbhara Pragna, Prakrushta Gnana or Bhuvana Gnana. And the answer is option number B, Rutumbhara Pragna. Now friends, the Sutra number 48 talks about Rutumbhara Pragna. What does it say? It says that Rutumbhara Tatra Pragna. Okay, now friends, the knowledge that is gained after having complete control over Nirvichara is known as Ritambara Pragna. Now friends, what is Ritambara Pragna? The one which gives knowledge of the truth is Ritambara Pragya. So let's bifurcate. Ritambara and Pragna. What is Ritambara? Knowledge that holds only the truth is Ritambara and a Pragna is Prakrushta Gnan. Now friends, also there can be a question that which is the knowledge that holds only the truth. So the answer is Ritambara Pragya. Thank you friends for watching this video. Hope this was useful for you. Please share this video with all those who are appearing for NET exam, QCI exam or any other competitive exam about yoga. Please like our channel, subscribe to our channel to get regular updates. And also do not forget to check the previous videos that I had made about some of the MCQs of Patanjali Yoga Darshan, Hatha Yoga and also June 2019 salt paper with detailed explanation about UGC NET exam. So friends, thank you so much. Dhanyavaad.